Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. In today's episode, let's look at using scroll bars in Mountain Lion. So with the release of Lion in 2011, scroll bars changed. Instead of automatically being there when needed, they only appear when you're actually scrolling. At least it depends on your settings. So for instance, here in this Finder window, we can see we have more items that can fit in the window at this size, and there's no scroll bar here to click on. Instead, what you're supposed to do is use the trackpad with two fingers, or you could use two fingers on a Magic Mouse or a scroll wheel or some other scrolling device on another type of mouse. So I'm going to use two fingers here and scroll up, and you can see the scroll bar appears on the right and it will fade away after a second or so. Now if I actually move the cursor, it won't fade away. Instead, it will stay there and then it actually get larger in Mountain Lion when I hover over it, and now I can actually scroll up and down. But as soon as I move over here and stop moving the mouse, it disappears again. And notice also I got a horizontal scroll bar at the bottom, and the same thing here. If I keep moving the mouse, as I may actually get there and I go to it, it gets larger. I can now use it, and then I move up here and I stop moving the mouse and it will then go away. Now you can change this by going to System Preferences to General, and here you have a couple settings. Here you have Show Scroll Bars is the important one. You have three settings, and one here is Always, and turning on Always means that the scroll bars will always appear just like they did before Lion. The alternative to that is Only When Scrolling, and the default is Automatically based on mouse or trackpad. So what happens here is if I have a mouse plugged into my computer, then I will get the scroll bars always showing, and if I have a trackpad, then they will only show when scrolling. So it kind of switches between the two of them, handy for people that say have a computer and switch between the two. But if you have both installed, then since there's a trackpad installed, the scroll bars will only be there when scrolling. So let's take a look at the two real alternatives. If I click Always and I look here, I can see now there are scroll bars at the document window. If I go and say Only When Scrolling, you can see they disappear. So you also have some keyboard alternatives to using the scroll bars. For instance, if I just use the arrow keys, it will select an item, the first item here since I had nothing selected, and I can go down, and as I continue to move down items, the scroll bars will appear and move as you would expect as I move with my selection there. Now, if I don't want it to actually select anything, I can actually hold the FN key on the keyboard and use the up and down arrows and will actually scroll for me. In this case, it's a very short little window, so it just scrolls all the way to the bottom immediately and to the top. Basically, the FN key and the up and down arrows are giving you page up and page down ability. So here I am in Safari, for instance, and here I can see if I scroll up and down using two fingers on my trackpad, the scroll bar appears and then it goes away. Likewise, if I keep the mouse moving, it will stay there and then get larger as I hover over it. And if I stop moving, it will go away. And if I use the function key, the FN key, and up and down, it will jump basically an entire page at a time. Likewise, the FN key and the left and right arrows act as the beginning and end buttons on extended keyboard, so I can jump all the way to the bottom or all the way to the top. Also, in some applications like Safari, you can just use the up and down arrow keys to scroll a slight amount or even hold it down to kind of do a continuous scroll. And I can do it with left and right as well. So you have that ability. It doesn't work on something like the Finder because using arrow keys to move between selections. But here in a browser, you don't move between selections like that. So you're able to actually control scrolling with the arrow keys. No mouse, trackpad, or any cursor movement needed at all. So what do I use? I leave it on the default, which basically means with my trackpad I don't see the scroll bars until I need them. However, one instance where it's handy to have the scroll bars always on is if I'm using screen sharing to control one Mac from another. Then it's really handy since I can't really do the scrolling and it really doesn't understand that I can't. So having scrolling turned on always for that situation is useful. Otherwise, I try to stick with the default. I try to use the arrow keys a lot, but most of the time I just use two fingers on the trackpad. If you've been using computers for a long time, you may not be used to that, so it may take some adjustment to get used to it, but it's well worth it. It's much easier to control the scrolling on a page with two fingers on a trackpad than it ever was to do using scroll bars. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.